Hello everyone. Welcome to our channel, Information Briefcase. Today we're going to learn about does anesthesia work when you are in medical procedure. Now, let's begin. If you've had a medical procedure, you may recall beginning to count in reverse from 10-9-8 and afterward awakening with the medical procedure currently over before you even got to 5. Also, it may appear as though you were sleeping, however you weren't. You were under sedation, which is very complex. You were not conscious, you likewise couldn't move, recollect memory, or feel any pain. Without having the option to give anesthesia and bring the body and mind under control, numerous medical procedures would be too horrific to even consider performing. Old clinical texts from Egypt, Asia, and the Middle East all depict early types of sedatives containing things like opium poppy, mandrake fruit, also liquor. Today, anesthesiologists frequently consolidate local, inhalational, and intravenous anesthesia to get the right equilibrium for a medical procedure. Local sedation blocks pain signals from a particular piece of the body to getting to the brain. Pain and different messages travel through the sensory system as electrical signals. Territorial sedatives work by setting up an electrical blockade. They tie to the proteins in neurons' cell films that let charged particles in and out. Furthermore, lock out decidedly charged particles. One compound that does this is cocaine, whose pain-killing impacts were found coincidentally at the point when an ophthalmology assistant got some on his tongue. It's still sometimes utilized as a sedative. However, large numbers of the more normal provincial sedatives have the same synthetic construction and work the same way. However, for significant medical procedures, where you should be sedated, you'll need something that follows up on the whole sensory system, including brain. That is the thing that inhalational sedatives do. In Western medication, diethyl ether was the main normal one. It was most popular as a sporting medication until specialists began to understand that individuals didn't notice wounds when they are in medication. During the 1840s, they began calming patients with diethyl ether during dental extractions and medical procedures. Nitrous oxide became famous in the many years, and it is still utilized today, despite the fact that ether subsidiaries, as sevoflurane, are more normal. Inhalational sedation is generally enhanced with intravenous sedation, which was created during the 1870s. Normal intravenous specialists incorporate tranquilizers, as propofol, which prompt sedation, and narcotics, similar to fentanyl, which diminish pain. These overall sedatives additionally appear to work by affecting electrical signs in the sensory system. Typically, the brain electrical signs are in non-sync tune as various parts of the cerebrum speak with one another. This network keeps you conscious and mindful. Be that as it may, as somebody becomes anesthetized, those signs become more settled and more coordinated, recommending that various pieces of the mind aren't conversing with one another any longer. There's a ton of things we actually don't know about precisely how this occurs. A few normal sedatives tie to the GABA receptor in the mind's neurons. They hold the passage open, allowing negatively charged particles to stream into the cell. Negative energize assembles and behaves like a traffic jam, holding the neuron back from communicating electrical signs. The sensory system has a lot of these gated channels controlling pathways for development, memory, and awareness. Most sedatives not only affect brain, numerous sedatives additionally influence the heart and lungs, also other crucial organs. Actually, like early sedatives, which included recognizable toxins like hemlock and aconite, present-day medications can have many side effects. So an anesthesiologist needs to blend the perfect equilibrium of medications to make all elements of sedation work properly, while cautiously observing the patient's important bodily functions and changing the medication blend on a case-by-case basis. Sedation is very complex. However, sorting out some way to utilize it helped great advancement of new and better careful strategies. Specialists could figure out how to regularly and securely perform C-section, perform open heart surgeries, do livers and kidney transplant. Furthermore, numerous other life-saving activities. What's more, every year, new sedation procedures are created that will guarantee an ever-increasing number of patients endure the injury of medical procedure. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment below. Please press the bell button to get notifications.